Kids, hello fifth class. So we had been studying chapter number 2, food and health. So last time we studied about water and roughage. Let's revise again, then we will begin disease, the remaining topic. The last topic was disease. We studied the last topic was disease. We will again begin. But let's revise. What is balanced diet? Function of water and roughage. Okay. So, what is balanced diet? A diet which contains the right amount of carbohydrate, fat, vitamins, minerals, water and roughage to meet the daily requirements of the body. Yes. What is balanced diet? A diet which contains the right amount of carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, minerals, water, roughage to meet the daily requirement of body. And balance, we need it, we need all these component according to age, activities, and varies with lifestyle. So all these varies with lifestyle. Okay, why should we eat a balanced diet? Because if you eat more, then you exercise. Yes, if you eat more, then you exercise. It can lead to obesity, means it can lead to overweight. But if you eat less, it can lead to malnutrition, starvation. So equal amount of eating and exercising will help you to live a healthy life. Water is very essential. We use water for drinking, cooking, mopping, bathing. And what are the main function of water? Let's see. It helps to transport nutrients. It carries away waste. It take away waste. It moisten an eye, mouth, nose, hydrates skin. Yes. It moisten an eye, mouth, nose and hydrates skin. It takes away. It carries away waste. It transports nutrients. Forms main component of body fluids. It is act as an insulator. And protect against heat exhaustion. It maintain our temperature of body. Lubricate joint. Yes, it makes joint soft. It protect from friction. Help with digestion. Yes, it helps in digestion. And what is roughage? Means dietary fiber. Roughage is also called dietary fiber. Yes, roughage is also known as dietary fibers. They consist of indigestible plant carbohydrate. Yes, we already know called it cellulose, which are the sources of roughage. Salad, vegetable, fresh fruit, all these are sources. As you can see on the screen, roughage is very essential component. What are the functions of roughage? The roughage help to get rid of undigested food. Yes, they help to remove waste, and it also help to prevent constipation. Okay, we had completed all this topic. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, next topic is disease. What is a disease? Last time we studied, but now we will study in detail. Okay. So what is disease? A disease is a state in which a function or part of body is no longer in the healthy condition. Yes. Disease is that condition in which your organ does not work properly or any part of body is not healthy. Yes, is not healthy. So there are two type of disease, communicable disease and non-communicable disease. Today we will discuss only about communicable disease. Yes. Today we will discuss only about communicable disease. In next class we will study about non-communicable disease. So what is disease? Disease is a condition in which function or part of the body is no longer in a healthy condition. You know, last time when we studied in last class, previous class, I had shown you some disease due to vitamin shortage, due to mineral shortage, All these are non-communicable disease. All these are non-communicable. Vitamin A, you know that due to shortage of vitamin A, we suffer from loss of vision deficiency disease, means blindness. You may also suffer from complete loss of vision or loss of vision at night, darkness. You cannot see clearly, you will see blur. Vitamin B1, if you don't eat vitamin B1, the deficiency disease due to shortage of vitamin B1 is beriberi. And the deficiency disease due to shortage of vitamin C is scurvy. And due to shortage of vitamin D, we suffer from which disease? We suffer from Rickets disease, yes. Bones become soft and bent. And we also watched the disease related to iodine, calcium, iron. Not eating iron, you will suffer from anemia disease. Due to shortage of iodine, you will suffer from goiter disease. Iodine is present in salt. So you need salt in micro quantity, okay? So you should eat iodized salt. Calcium is present in milk, okay? Without calcium, you will suffer from bones and tooth decay. Your bones will become weak, tooth decay will start. Now, let's begin communicable disease. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, first topic is communicable disease. As you can see some pictures on the screen which are showing communicable disease. First picture, malaria. Second picture, HIV. Third is chickenpox. In your book, only given about malaria, so we'll study about malaria. HIV is not given, chickenpox is not given. But remember that they are very dangerous disease. Yes, HIV is so dangerous disease. Malaria. Yes. So, malaria disease occurred due to biting female mosquito. Yes, when mosquito bite, malaria disease. Remember kids, due to male mosquito, malaria disease does not occur. Yes, due to male mosquito, malaria disease does not occur. It occurs due to biting female mosquito. What is the name of that mosquito? Anopheles, yes, A-N-O-P-H-E-L-E-S, Anopheles. In next class we will study about it. Anopheles mosquito, when Anopheles mosquito bite, you suffer from malaria disease. Now, think kids, dengue, what is the reason behind dengue disease? I'm not going to tell you, I will tell later. I will tell you in next class. So find out answer yourself. What is the name of mosquito? Which mosquito is responsible for dengue disease? You can see the picture of HIV and chickenpox disease. So all these are communicable diseases. Yes, they can transfer from one person to another person. They can transfer from one person to another person. Okay, I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, now let's see the introduction of non-communicable disease. Then we will discuss in detail about communicable disease. Okay, non-communicable disease. As you can see on the screen, look the first picture. Cardiovascular disease. The first picture is actually heart picture. Your heart, yes, your heart look like this. cardiovascular disease, this is the picture of your heart. Cancer, yes. Next is respiratory disease, breathing related problem. Last picture you can see diabetes, yes. All these are non-communicable disease. They do not transfer from one person to another. Cardiovascular disease, yes. Look the first picture, cardiovascular disease. It is actually related to heart disease, yes. Cardiovascular disease is heart disease. Cancer, yes. Cancer may happen due to growth of cells. It also happened due to smoking. Many people smoke, drink, eat tobacco. You can suffer from cancer. Respiratory problem, yes. Breathing related problem, possible due to smoking. Diabetes. Diabetes can happen if you are eating so much sugar, sweet. So don't eat so much sweet. All these are non-communicable diseases. Cardiovascular disease, cancer, respiratory disease, and diabetes. So we need to take care our body from different disease, yes. That's why it is said that you should do exercise, you should eat balanced diet. Healthy lifestyle is very important. Don't drink alcohol, don't smoke. So all these are non-communicable diseases. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, so now let's begin our main topic, communicable disease, yes. So you know that malaria, HIV, chickenpox, all these are communicable disease. Chickenpox was discovered by Edward Jenner. So first question is, what is the meaning of communicable disease? Yes. What do you mean by communicable disease? Disease is that spread from one person to another person. Yes. Disease that spread, that can transfer from one person to other person. It's called communicable diseases. Yes. Whatever written on the screen, please write down in your notebook. These diseases actually are catching diseases. Yes. Diseases that are catching, that can catch the body, another human's body, another person's body. They can transfer, they can spread from healthy person to, they can spread from unhealthy person to healthy person. Yes. So all these are communicable disease. So disease that are spread from one person to other, disease that spread from one person to another are called communicable disease. And what is the reason behind it? Cause. How does it happen? What is the reason? These diseases are caused by germs, or you can say pathogen. Yes, pathogen are harmful organisms, or you can say germs. Yes, communicable diseases are caused by germs or pathogen. There are many pathogens, harmful microorganisms. Microorganism means small organisms. You cannot see with naked eye. You need a microscope. You need a microscope to watch these germs or pathogen. These germs or pathogen, these small microorganisms, you need a microscope to watch them, like virus, bacteria, parasite, worm, fungi. All these are communicable pathogen. Yes. So due to pathogen, communicable disease occur. I'm giving you 10 seconds, please write down all these. So, once again, what are communicable disease? Disease is that spread from one person to another person, yes. Transfer from one person to other person, unhealthy person to healthy person. These diseases are caused by germs or pathogen. Yes, these diseases are actually catching disease. Example of pathogen, virus, bacteria, parasitic worms, fungi. Okay, hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. So kids, we discussed about pathogen. Pathogen are microorganisms, pathogen are microorganisms. You cannot see with unaided eye, means you cannot see with naked eye. You need a microscope to watch them. You need a microscope to watch them. As you can see the picture of bacteria, virus and protozoa. Yes, you can see the picture of bacteria, virus and protozoa. These pictures are not given in your book. These pictures are not given in your book, but you can draw them if you wish. You can see bacterium picture, virus picture and protozoa picture. So there are many type of bacteria. Yes, rod shaped bacteria, spiral bacteria, virus. There are many type of virus like mycobacterium, bacteriophage, protozoa like amoeba, paramecium. All these are protozoa. They are harmful. But remember, not all bacteria are harmful. Yes, all the bacteria are not harmful. Do you know many bacteria are present in your mouth? Many bacteria are present in your mouth, but they are not harmful. Yes. Many bacteria are present in our clothes, but they are not harmful. But some bacteria are very harmful, like rod shaped bacteria, spiral bacteria. Virus like bacteriophage is harmful. Protozoa, amoeba, paramecium. So all these are pathogen. Fungi, yes. Fungi are also pathogen. Fungi are also pathogen, like penicillium. Penicillium is Aspergillus, all these are pathogen. Okay, bread mold is also a fungi which you see on the bread. Okay, so we know that malaria, HIV and chickenpox, all these are communicable disease. All these happen due to pathogen. Now let's see some disease. Let's talk about some disease like TB, common cold, cough, pneumonia. How do they spread? What is the reason? How to protect? How can we protect ourselves? How to prevent? We will study about all these disease in detail. Okay. Let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, TB. At first we will discuss about TB. Tuberculosis, yes. TB means tuberculosis. I think you might have heard the name of TB. You already know the word TB, it means tuberculosis. Okay. So first, Communicable disease is TB. So what is TB? What is tuberculosis? Tuberculosis is defined as an infectious disease caused by a bacterium called Mycobacterium TB that most commonly affect the lungs. Yes, tuberculosis is defined as an infectious disease caused by bacterium Mycobacterium TB that most commonly affect the lungs. So TB occur due to bacteria. Yes, which pathogen is responsible for TB disease? Bacteria. Yes, bacteria is responsible for TB disease. Which bacteria? What is the name of bacteria? The name of bacteria is Mycobacterium TB. Mycobacterium tuberculosis is responsible for TB disease. Yes. And it affects the lungs. Yes. It affects the lungs. L-U-N-G-S. It affects the lungs. So, tuberculosis is defined as an infectious disease caused by which bacteria? Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which most effectively affect the lungs. Yes. It can harm your lungs. Yes, it is very harmful for your lungs. Now the question is, what are the symptoms? How can you recognize? How can we know? How do we know that we are suffering from TB disease? As you can see on the screen, symptoms: slight fever. Yes, you may have fever, not too much, slight fever. Night sweat. Yes, sweat will come out from your body at night. Weight loss. Yes, your body weight lose, your body weight decrease. Fatigue. You will feel tiredness. Yes, tiredness. Even doing less work, if you don't do too much work, still you will feel fatigue. Yes. So slight fever, night sweat, weight loss, fatigue, all these are the symptoms. Now, mode of transmission. How does it transfer? Tuberculosis is an airborne disease that able to pass from one person to another person. Yes. If you cough, it can transfer from one person to another person. Yes. Because it is communicable disease. So we can say it is airborne disease. When you cough, the cough will go into another healthy person body, then he will also suffer from the same disease. Communicable disease. So all these are the symptoms, mode of transmission. Please write down all. I'm giving you 10 seconds. Please write down. Okay, kids. So what is TB? Tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is defined as an infectious disease caused by bacterium. Which bacterium? Mycobacterium tuberculosis, that most commonly affect the lungs. It is infectious disease. Yes. It means it is transferable. It is communicable. Symptoms like fever, night sweat, weight loss, fatigue. Modes of transmission: tuberculosis is an airborne disease able to pass from one person to another. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, now we'll talk about the next disease, pneumonia. Please pay attention on the spelling. What is the spelling of pneumonia? Check out the spelling. Yes. The spelling of pneumonia is P, begins with P, not with N. Yes, the spelling of pneumonia begins with P. PNEUMONIA, pneumonia. Pneumonia is also infectious disease. It is communicable disease. So what is pneumonia? What is pneumonia? Pneumonia is an infection deep in the lungs, usually caused by virus or bacteria. Yes. Pneumonia is lungs disease. Yes, it infects the lungs. It is caused by virus. Yes, mostly pneumonia goes by virus. But sometimes it is also caused by bacteria. It affects the lungs. You can see the picture. This is the part of lungs. You can see the picture. This is the internal part of lungs. Yes, internal part of lung. So it affects the lungs. Yes. So when you will suffer from pneumonia disease, then you will suffer from breathing related problem also. Yes, breathing related problem. So pneumonia is an infectious disease which occurs deep in the lungs. Yes, it affects the blood vessels of lungs. It affects the bronchioles. It is caused by virus and bacteria, but mostly it is caused by virus. Okay, please write down. I'm giving you 5 seconds. It will not take too time to write down. Please write. So what is pneumonia? Pneumonia is an infection deep in the lungs, usually caused by virus. I hope you understood. Now the question is, what are the symptoms? What are the symptoms and how to prevent, how to protect ourselves from pneumonia? Let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, at first we will see the symptoms of pneumonia. Yes, what are the symptoms of pneumonia? Can you see on the screen? First symptom, muscle ache. Muscle ache, M-U-S-C-L-E-A-C-H-E-S, muscle aches. X means pain. Yes, muscle pain. Your muscles will pain. Yes, your neck will pain, your legs will pain. Yes, they all will ache. So if you feel muscles pain too much, maybe you are suffering from pneumonia. Dry cough. Yes, dry cough. Along with muscles ache, you can suffer from dry cough. Not simple cough, dry cough. Abdominal pain. Yes. Next, look the picture of abdominal pain. Abdominal, this spelling of abdominal is A-B-D-O-M-I-N-A-L. A-B-D-O-M-I-N-A-L, abdominal pain. What is the meaning of abdominal? Stomach. Yes. Stomach pain means stomach ache. Yes, you will suffer from abdominal pain. Next is cold in the head or throat. Yes, maybe you will suffer from cold. Fever with shivering. Yes, fever with shivering. You will suffer, you will have fever, but along with shivering, shivering means vibration. Your body will vibrate, start vibrating, shivering. Fever. Chest pain. Yes, you can suffer from chest pain. Yes, your chest will pain because it means it is affecting on your lungs. Nausea. Yes, nose bleeding may be possible. Nausea means nose bleed. N-A-U-S-E-A, nausea means nose bleed. Vomiting. Yes, you can also suffer from vomiting, vomit problem. It is also possible. So what are the symptoms of pneumonia? Muscles ache, dry cough, abdominal pain means stomach pain, cold in the heat, fever with shivering, chest pain, nausea and vomiting. Okay, all these are the symptoms of pneumonia. Please write down spelling of muscles ache. Spelling of muscles ache. MUSCLEACHES. Muscles ache. MUSCLEACHES. Muscles ache. What is the spelling of dry cough? DRY COUGH. DRY COUGH. Dry cough. What is the spelling of abdominal pain? ABDOMINL. Abdominal. ABDOMINL. Abdominal pain. 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 So ABDOMINL. Abdominal. PAIN. Pain. Abdominal. Cold. 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 Fever with shivering. Fever. 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 Fever with. 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 Shivering. 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 Chest pain. What is the spelling of chest pain? CHEST. Chest. PAIN. Pain. Chest pain. What is the spelling of nausea and vomiting? NAUSEA. 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 Vomiting. 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 I hope you understood. Now let's move on then. Prevention of pneumonia. Okay kids, how can we prevent from pneumonia? I have written 4 points. Point number one, reducing exposure to indoor and air pollution. Point number one, reducing exposure to indoor air pollution. Yes, indoor air pollution. Remove the air pollution, yes, because air pollution affects the lungs. So remove air pollution, reduce air pollution. You already know about air pollution. You might have studied in whole class. When air becomes polluted, air gets polluted, we suffer from air pollution. So reduce air pollution. Next is adequate nutrition. Yes, adequate nutrition means you should eat balanced diet. You should eat enough nutrients. Yes, should eat properly. You should eat healthy food. Immunization. Next is immunization. Please check out the spelling IMMUNIZATION. Spelling IMMUNIZATION. Immunization. Means you should take antibiotics, vaccine, improve immunity system. Yes, healthy food can improve. Exercise, you should do exercise. Take antibiotics. Yes, take antibiotics. Take medicine in case of pneumonia. Next is avoiding smoking near children. Yes, smoke. Air pollution avoid from children. Do not smoke, please. Smoking is not good. Smoking is injurious to health. Improving housing condition. Last point, improving housing condition. Yes. We need to keep our house neat and clean. We need to keep house clean. Because there are many bacteria, virus present in dust and smoke. They are very harmful, dust and smoke. They can affect the lungs. Then we can suffer from pneumonia disease. Please write down all these points. Reducing exposure to indoor air pollution. Adequate nutrition. Immunization. Avoiding smoking near children. Improving housing condition. Please write down. I am giving you 10 seconds. Okay. So what are the 4 points how to prevent from pneumonia? Point number one, reducing exposure to indoor air pollution. Point number two, adequate nutrition means enough amount of nutrition you should take. Immunization means antibiotics, take antibiotics. avoid smoking near children. Yes, avoid smoking near children. Improve housing condition. These are the four. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, now let's talk about common cold. Yes. As you can see on the screen, a girl is clearing. She is clearing her nose. Yes. She is clearing her nose with a handkerchief. Yes. Why? Because she is suffering from common cold disease. Yes, my dear kids. That girl is suffering from common cold disease. So what is common cold disease? What are the symptoms and how to prevent from it? We will study all. Usually common cold disease occur when environment change suddenly. Yes, when environment change suddenly or during winter season we face it more. Yes. Winter season we face common cold and cough. Yes, am I right? So we need to protect ourselves. Isn't it surprising, my dear friends, that common cold occurred due to virus? Yes, common cold occurred due to virus. Yes. So virus is responsible for common cold disease. There are many diseases which occurs because of virus. Even HIV. In the beginning I showed you, I told you about HIV. Did you remember? Yes, HIV. It also occurred due to virus. Yes. And polio is also happened due to virus. You know, sometime Indian government organized pulse polio abhiyan. Under this program, polio is given to children whose age is 1 to 5. Polio is a vaccine. Yes, polio is actually antibiotics. It is a vaccine. It prevents from many diseases. Polio prevents from many diseases. Yes. Okay. So now let's see the symptoms of polio. Sorry, let's see the symptoms of cold. Then at last I will show you the pictures related to polio. Okay, last I will show you the pictures related to polio. Now let's see the symptoms. Let's move on to the next one. Okay kids, what are the symptoms of common cold? Cough. Yes, cough is the symptoms of common cold. Headache may be possible during common cold. Heat. Yes, the temperature of your body increases. Cold means your nose run. Sore throat. Yes, your throat, you do not feel good with your throat. Yes, so these are the symptoms. These are 5 symptoms, main symptom, major symptoms of if you suffer from cold: cough, headache, heat, cold, sore throat. Please write down all these spelling. What is the spelling of cough? C-O-U-G-H, C-O-U-G-H, cough. What is the spelling of headache? H-E-A-D-A-C-H, headache. Means your head will pain, head pain. Heat, H-E-A-T, heat, means body temperature. Cold, C-O-L-D, cold, means your nose start running, so you use again and again handkerchief. And sore throat, yes, you doesn't feel good from your throat. Yes, you will feel something rough from your throat. Okay, please write down the spelling. I'm giving you 10 seconds. write down these symptoms. Okay kids, so what are the symptoms? Cough, cold, headache, heat, sore throat. These are the symptoms. Now the question is how to protect? How can we prevent ourselves from all these? I will show you four ways to protect from you. 4 points, okay? Because what happens during common cold? We sneeze again and again, yes. We sneeze again and again. We cough. We cough again and again. Yes. Maybe your head will pan. So how to prevent? What are the prevention? Let's move on to the next point. As you can see on the screen, I have shown few prevention, how to protect ourselves, prevention of common cold. First picture, look at the first picture, vaccination, yes, injection, vaccine, antibiotics are necessary. VACCINATIN, vaccine. We will study the meaning of vaccination later in detail. What is vaccine? What is the meaning of vaccination? Why do we need detail? We study in next class. Okay, in next class we will study about it. So vaccination injection is given sometime, and vaccine, antibiotics you should take. Hand wash, yes, wash hand. You should wash hand every day properly, regularly. You know, right now COVID-19, coronavirus is spreading, and common cold, it is said that common cold is actually a kind of corona. This is also symptom, common cold is also symptoms of coronavirus. You should use mask, yes, gauze mask, N95 mask you should use, which can prevent, because this is a communicable disease. So when you sneeze, the droplets coming out from your nose through air, they can transfer from unhealthy to healthy person. And the next person, the person which is in front of you when you are sneezing, he will also suffer from the common cold. Yes. You should take vitamins. Take vitamins. Eat vitamin rich food. Yes. Take vitamin A, vitamin B, C, D, E, K. Are very important for healthy life. So, vaccination, wash hand, use gauze mask and take vitamin. These are the four prevention. Please write down this. What is the spelling of vaccination? VACCINATION, vaccination. What is the spelling of hand wash? HAND, hand, WS, wash. Gauze mask, GAUZE, gauze, MSK, mask. Vitamins, VATAMINS, vitamins. Okay. Please write down. I'm giving you 10 seconds. Okay kids, so these are the four prevention: vaccination, wash hand, gauze mask, use gauze mask, and use vitamin, take vitamin. Okay, now let's see the next point. Okay, as I said you about polio occurred due to virus. Polio is not given in your book, but just for your information I am showing you the picture. As I said, the under pulse polio Abhiyan in government school pulse vaccine is given. Which vaccine? Polio vaccine in the form of liquid. It is given, generally 2 to 5 drops are given, and you can see in the picture polio vaccine is being given to a child. Can you see the picture? And look there, one more picture I have shown. You can see some disabled boy. You can see some disabled boy. Because they did not get polio vaccine in childhood. That's why they are suffering from this disease. You might have seen such kind of person. Yes, so polio is very important vaccine. So if you have brother, sister whose age is less than 5, whenever Pulse Polio Abhiyan organize, please take them for polio vaccine, because otherwise you can suffer, they can suffer from disabled problem, mental disability also possible. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the last point. Okay kids, it's time to ask question from you. Question number one is, write the symptoms and prevention of common cold and pneumonia. Yes, write the symptoms and prevention of common cold and pneumonia. Okay, so let's talk about, first we will talk about common cold symptoms and prevention, then we will talk about pneumonia. So common cold, which are the symptoms of common cold? Cough, headache, heat, cold, sore throat. Yes, these are the symptoms. 5 symptoms. Cough, symptom number 1, cough. Symptom number 2, headache. Symptom number 3, heat. Symptom number 4, cold. Symptom number 5, sore throat. Cough, cold, headache, sore throat. What are the prevention? There are 4 prevention. Vaccination, wash hand regularly, use gauze mask, vitamins, take vitamins. So, vaccination, wash hand, gauze mask, vitamins. These are the prevention. Okay? These are the prevention. And pneumonia. What are the symptoms of pneumonia? Muscles ache, dry cough, abdominal pain, cold, fever with shivering, chest pain, nausea and vomiting. So, symptoms of pneumonia. Symptom number 1, muscles ache. Symptom number 2, dry cough. Symptom number 3, abdominal pain. Symptom number 4, cold in the head. Symptom number 5, fever with shivering. Symptom number 6, chest pain. Symptom number 7, nausea and vomiting. These are the symptoms. Next question. Which bacteria is responsible for TB? TB means tuberculosis. Yes. Which bacteria is responsible? Yes. Mycobacterium tuberculosis bacteria is responsible for TB. Yes. Mycobacterium tuberculosis bacteria is responsible for TB. And which are the symptoms of TB? Slight fever, night sweat, weight loss, fatigue. Yes, tiredness. Slight fever. Fever, not too much, but slight. Night sweat, weight loss, fatigue. These are the symptoms of fever. And it is airborne disease. So what is the mode of transmission? Tuberculosis is an airborne disease that able to pass from one person to another. In the same way, common cold is also airborne disease which can pass from one person to another. Next question is, define communicable disease. Question number 3, define communicable disease. So what is communicable disease? Disease that can spread from one person to another are called communicable disease. Disease that can spread from one person to another are called communicable disease. So, TB, pneumonia, common cold, HIV, chickenpox, malaria, all these are common cold. Yes, TB, chickenpox, malaria, HIV, common cold, pneumonia, all these are communicable disease. Okay, I hope that you understood communicable disease. Now we will meet in next class with new topic. Till then, goodbye.